The USGS has been collecting streamflow data in Arizona since the 1890s, and over 200 stream gauges are in operation in the state today. Traditionally, collecting streamflow data requires a hydrographer to travel to the gauge to verify discharge during the flow. But given the remote nature of many of our gauges, we are working to develop new techniques that will help us collect more reliable streamflow data at our hard-to-reach gauges. In order to ensure that these methods will meet USGS standards, they need to be tested in a controlled environment. The Walnut Gulch Experimental Watershed in Tombstone, Arizona, provided our team with the perfect setting to develop an experiment to test these methods.
My name is Brandon Forbes. I'm a hydrologist with the USGS out of Tucson, Arizona. And today we're back at Walnut Gulch Experimental Watershed. We're at Flume 6. We had a great monsoon flow. We're able to capture the entire flood on all of our sensors. And today we're going to GPS survey in the sensors, the cross sections at each sensor, and all the high water marks are so we can make sure the stage sensors worked well. And once we have that, we'll be able to calibrate both 1 and 2D flow models to the record collected at the flume to see how well we're actually able to recreate the flow that occurred here.
These watersheds in Walnut Gulch are meant to measure very intensively. So in this 60 square mile watershed, we have over 100 recording rain gauges, and we have almost 30 nested watersheds that are gauged with instrumentation like these flumes and several other designs. Walnut Gulch Experimental Watershed has been used for a variety of collaboration. And in this particular instance, we're working with the local USGS Science Center, and they have to set up gauging stations all over the state of Arizona where they don't have these big structures and these flumes like this. So this allows them to basically validate their methodology. And because you have fixed geometry and you know the slope, you can compute the discharge if you know the depth of flow within this.
A recent advance in surveying within the USGS is the use of unmanned aerial vehicles, or UAVs. UAVs provide an efficient way to collect data at our sites by documenting the conditions of the channel on the day of the survey. But what we are most interested in collecting from these aerial surveys is topographic data. In this experiment, we flew a UAV above the channel to take high-resolution photographs. Within the data collected from these flights, we can build a digital elevation model of our channel. Furthermore, by analyzing the images on a pixel-by-pixel basis, we can better document current channel conditions, including channel roughness, and create what is known as a 2D flow model. This model can simulate different magnitudes of flow through the system, which ultimately allows us to gain knowledge of all the potential flow scenarios of that watershed.
This reach-scale experiment at Walnut Gulch has provided us with very valuable data. We tested the continuous slope area method during this experiment, and we were able to verify the accuracy of the CSA method by comparing the discharge computed using our sensors with the true discharge measured by Flume 6. After reviewing the data gathered from our indirect measurement, the CSA sensors, and the flume, we were able to begin our analysis. We used the surveyed high water marks to do a slope area computation to determine stream flow at the peak of the event. Without the CSA sensors in the channel, this peak discharge value would be the only measurement available after a flow event. Our CSA sensors measure water depth every 5 minutes, allowing us to determine stream flow in 5-minute intervals. With that data, we can then compare the entire event recorded by our sensors to the discharge measured by the flume. After reviewing the data, we determined that the CSA sensors can compute flow above approximately 800 cubic feet per second. We did experience some discrepancy in the beginning of the hydrograph, which may be due to challenges measuring water depth as it was rapidly changing. However, when we compared the rest of the streamflow data computed by the sensors to what was recorded by the flume, we found that our methods were accurate, within 5% of the true discharge. Measuring accurate discharge during an entire event without requiring a hydrographer to be present during the flood is a significant step forward for our stream gauges. With this one event at Walnut Gulch, we were able to create an accurate rating curve for our continuous slope area reach, showing that the CSA method can be used to improve the quality of data collected at gauges where we can't easily measure during floods. We are excited by the results of this experiment and are planning additional installations using the continuous slope area method across the state. We hope to be able to remotely collect reliable streamflow data to provide accurate information to our partners and citizens throughout Arizona. We will be continuing the Advances in Streamgaging series with follow-up videos on the progress of our field applications, and we'll soon be highlighting a step-by-step process on how we produce our results. If you have questions or comments, feel free to contact us at the Arizona Water Science Center. Thanks for tuning in.